Are you tired of this? You buy a perfect, gorgeous green avocado, use half for your toast, and promise yourself you'll save the other half for later. But when later comes, you open the fridge to find this sad, brown, unappetizing mess. It's that feeling of kitchen frustration we've all had. You wasted food, you wasted money, and your guacamole plans are officially dead. You've probably heard all the tricks, right? Rub it with lemon juice, store it with an onion, leave the pit in. But how many of these are just old kitchen myths, and which ones are actual game changers? Well, today, we're ending the guesswork. We're putting the three most popular methods to a head-to-head test to find out, once and for all, how to stop avocados from turning brown. We're going to find the one true hack that keeps your avocado looking as fresh as the second you cut it. Before we jump into our food hacks, let us try to understand our whys. Why do avocados, or apples, or bananas, pull this browning trick on us? The culprit is a tiny enzyme called polyphenol oxidase. We'll just call it PPO. So, PPO is an enzyme that hangs out inside the avocado's cells. As long as the avocado is whole, the PPO and other things called phenols are kept in their own little separate rooms inside the plant cells. They're living peacefully, not bothering each other at all. But the second you slice into that creamy green flesh, you're causing chaos on a microscopic level. You're breaking down those cell walls, and for the first time ever, the PPO enzyme and the phenols get to mix. All they need now to start the browning process is one last ingredient, which is oxygen. As soon as the avocado flesh is exposed to air, the PPO enzyme uses oxygen to start a chemical reaction. This chemical reaction turns those phenols into new things called quinones. These quinones then chain together to form what we see as that gross brown pigment. So, just to be clear, a brown avocado isn't rotten. It's just gone through a very fast, very visible chemical reaction. The good news is, browning reactions can be slowed or blocked, and that is what we are going to try to do with these upcoming tests. So let us begin. First, I'm going to slice these avocados. You can see that they are all ripened perfectly. In my previous video, I shared important tips on picking a perfect, ripe avocado. I will be linking it to this video in the description, so please be sure to check it out if you've always struggled with choosing good avocados in the grocery store, because those tips work 100%. Okay, now back to our avocados. We'll look at three different ways to control browning in avocados, plus a control, and I am going to explain each one. The control is our baseline for what happens when you do absolutely nothing. I'm going to place one half of the avocado cut side up in this airtight container, which has already been labeled. We'll seal it and store it for 24 hours. The second one is the onion trick. This one feels more like something you'd see on the internet, but the science behind it is pretty interesting. Putting a smelly onion next to your creamy avocado might sound a little gross, but there's some interesting chemistry going on. When you cut an onion, it releases sulfur compounds. That's the stuff that makes you cry. The idea is that these same sulfur also mess with PPO, which is the browning enzyme in the avocado. The key here is that you don't want the onion to actually touch the avocado, because that would definitely make it taste like onion. The gases are supposed to do all the work. So, I'm chopping a thick slice of onion and putting it in the bottom of our second container. Then, I'm placing the avocado half right to the side, cut side up, making sure they don't touch. I'm sealing the labeled container, trapping the avocado in there with all those onion fumes. Honestly, this feels like a long shot. Is this a real under-the-radar trick or just a weird myth that's going to give us an onion-scented brown avocado? We're about to find out. Test 2 is now ready for its 24-hour test. If you're enjoying this video and will love to see more helpful tips like this, please hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so that you don't miss anything I upload. And also hit the like button. It's a free way of supporting us. I know you will enjoy being here with all the helpful tips I will be uploading. The third one is the lemon or lime juice trick. This is the trick your grandma probably taught you. The science here is pretty straightforward. That browning enzyme, PPO, is super picky about the environment it works in. It likes a neutral pH. The acid in lemon or lime juice drops the pH way down, creating an acidic surface that basically tries to shut the enzyme off. For this test, I have some freshly squeezed lime juice. I'll use my hand to rub the juice over the fruit and then place it in its labeled container and seal it. The one thing people worry about with this method is the taste. Is our avocado going to taste like a lime tomorrow? That's part of what we're testing, and we'll find out. The last test is the water bath test. This is the most direct approach. If oxygen is the problem, then the easiest solution should be to just get rid of the oxygen, right? That's what the water bath does. By putting the avocado underwater, you create a perfect physical barrier so no air can touch the flesh. No oxygen, no browning. It's simple and it's elegant. For this test, I'm taking our last avocado half and placing it cut side down in our third container. Then I'm just pouring cold tap water over it until it's completely covered. The whole cut surface is now totally protected from the air. The big question with this hack is texture. Are we going to trade perfect color for a mushy texture? Is that a good trade-off? That's what we're here to find out. I'm sealing the container, and our final hack is done. All three tests and our control are in the fridge. Now we wait for 24 hours. Where are you watching me from? Let's connect from around the world. Comment your city or country in the comments. And we've made subtitles in different languages, so you can watch this video in the language that you are most comfortable with. And if you don't see your language, please notify us in the comments section, and we'll be sure to include that. All right, the moment of truth is here. It's been 24 hours. Our four avocado halves have been sitting in the fridge, each one going through its own little test. Who survived the night, and who gave in to the brown? Let's get them out and see the results. First, let's check on our control. This is the avocado we did nothing to. And the results are, well, predictable. There's browning all over the sides and inside the avocado. The browning looks deep, and it looks completely gross. This is exactly what we're trying to prevent. Next, let's look at test number two, the onion hack. I noticed a little bit of onion smell when I opened the container, and the avocado itself looks good. It's way better than the control for sure. There's a small good amount of browning around the edges and some splotches on inside. It definitely slowed the browning down. The real deal breaker, though, was that slight oniony smell and taste on the surface. If you're making guacamole right away, maybe it's fine. Okay, now let's look at test number three, the lime juice. There are a couple of teeny tiny brown spots on the sides, but compared to the control, it's a night and day difference. We have some small amount of browning inside, and I'm guessing we may have missed that part with the lime juice, but all in all, it looks good. I gave it a taste, and there's a definite hint of lime, but it's not overpowering. For avocado toast or a salad, it would actually be pretty delicious. The texture is also perfect. Finally, our last test, the water bath. And this is incredible. It looks pretty good. But what about the texture? The very top layer is just a tiny bit softer, but it's barely noticeable. It's not the soggy mess I was afraid of at all. For keeping an avocado half perfect for a day, the water bath is the undeniable champion. It worked simply because it cut off the oxygen completely. So there you have it. The lime juice hack is a fantastic runner-up, but if you want to keep your avocado half looking absolutely flawless, the water bath is your new secret weapon. It's easy, it works, and it keeps that beautiful color perfectly. You never have to throw away a sad brown avocado ever again. If this video just saved your future avocados and some of your grocery money, do us a solid and hit that subscribe button and notification bell for more kitchen hacks that we actually test out. And now we want to hear from you. What's your go-to method for keeping avocados green? Do you have some family secret we didn't test? Drop it in the comments below. We read them all and are always looking for new things to try. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.